Dear brothers and sisters, today I would like to speak on a topic, a concept probably we are familiar with, that is struggle for existence and survival of the fittest. I repeat, struggle for existence and survival of the fittest. I have taken this concept from Darwinism, formulated centuries ago, and now it is very much true in human life, and we can apply to our present life. We can apply to the present condition of the human family today. Struggle for existence and survival of the fittest. Every creature born on earth wants to live and move. Once the creature starts living, it comes to know that it has to struggle for existence. It comes to know that it has to live among very many creatures which are bigger than, stronger than, more powerful than, mightier than. And this, for smaller creatures, it is a real struggle for existence. Taking into consideration the painful human experience, taking into consideration what has been happening around us nearly for the last 2 years due to this coronavirus, I would like to speak on this concept and apply to our very life. And I request all of you through this Catholic Hub TV to listen to think on and perceive the truth in it. Coronavirus challenged the humanity, the human life, challenged the world, challenged the world's economic condition, challenged the human health, challenged the science and technology, challenged our medication, challenged our ability to exist in spite of all these challenges. And who can survive? Answer to the question, who can survive amidst all these challenges, amidst the climatic changes, environmental changes, the economic conditions? Who can survive? I think we can learn a lesson from animal world. The smaller animal becomes a prey to the bigger. And if the bigger has to survive, it has to struggle. It has to struggle and hunt the smaller for its existence. At times it may not sound well, but it is the truth of life. If you want to exist, If you want to live on earth and have a being, if you want to move on earth, you have to struggle. Until the coming of the birth of coronavirus, the human world has taken for granted. It has taken for granted our relationships, our ability, bodily system, medical care, our economic conditions, our immunity system, and in a word, the world has taken for granted the human life. And now, it has become a struggle. Struggle for life. Struggle for breath. And all of us know very well, it breaks down the respiratory system of the human being, whereby the human person struggles for breath. And we know the human life is mere a breath. But for that breath, it is a struggle now. We watch it on TV. We read it in newspapers. We hear it. And we do experience painfully day by day this truth. From smaller to the bigger, from the poorest to the richest, the weakest to the mightiest, it has become a painful experience during this pandemic. And it has revealed how vulnerable is the human person, how fragile is the human person, that is you and I, to the changes, to the challenges, to the conditions, and what we have to do. And this experience teaches a lesson that we have to adapt ourselves to all these challenges, climatic changes, environmental changes, imperceptible virus, bacteria, diseases, wars, fights, and ultimately the fear within. The fear lurking in me, fear of death. After watching a terrible news on TV, thousands and thousands of people are just dying like that, thrown into the streets, no one to care for, no one to perform the last rites. What a life is this? What a life the human person is living on earth is merely a breath. But it is precious. We have lost our dear ones, our near ones, our closest. It is a painful experience. And all those who were affected terribly by this coronavirus. Who can survive? It is a reality in the society today. The mightiest, the richest, the biggest, well outspoken, the most powerful, the people who are in a position, power, money, fame, and a name, who are really the fittest, human words to speak about. Given utmost care, admitted in the best hospital, given the best treatment, in spite of the shortage of oxygen, it is given to them. To whom? To the richest, to the biggest, to the most powerful. We can't rule out amidst of them too. Some of them lost life in spite of all these attentions. But fact is, coming down to the life of the grassroots levels of the poor people in society, the majority of the people in society struck by this coronavirus, struggling terribly for existence. Poor has become the poorest. The middle class has become the poor, not able to afford medication, a proper treatment, oxygen, beds in hospital, and just dying on the streets, leaving the hope, helplessness, and just died. Died without any last rites, a decent burial. There are people lost the parents in the family. Children became parentless. There are parents who lost the children. There are families who lost the elders in the family. There are people who lost the parent, mother or father. And now their life is on the streets now. Struggling for a good, decent meal in a day. Struggling for existence. If you go out into the society and examine, observe very carefully and closely, it is true that if a poor person contracts with the coronavirus, can he afford to a good hospital, good medication, good treatment? Even though he gets or she gets the medication, what about the conditions of the hospitals today? It is a challenge. Coronavirus is challenging our medical system. It is not enough what we have today. The system has to be improved. The treatment, the medical science, the science and technology, what we have today is not enough. It has to be advanced. And the respiratory system that we have, the immunity system that we have developed is not enough. The coronavirus challenges that you have to grow stronger and stronger. And fear within me. Fear within the fear of death. And from which wells up anxiety, pressure, stress, mental breakdown, psychological depression, and spiritual negligence, the spiritual death. In a way, the human person is broken into pieces. It's a struggle for existence to put together and make a person whole. The wholesome person is a real challenge today. If I don't adapt myself to what is happening around me, the only way is to give up life. Struggle for existence. And who can survive? As we have reflected already, the richest, the biggest, the mightiest in the society. And this beautiful concept teaches a lesson. that we have to adapt ourselves to the changing conditions. We have to develop and advance our science and technology. We have to grow economically sound. We have to improve our health care. We have to develop ourselves bodily, mentally, psychologically, and spiritually. We have to pay attention to our system in and around. It is really a struggle for existence, dear brothers and sisters. And amidst all these struggles, maybe struggle with the poverty, struggle with the lack of oxygen, struggle with improper medication, struggle with no treatment, struggle with no hospitalization, struggle with corruption, struggle with poor immunity system, struggle with no proper food, struggle with no person to stand by, struggle with no people around me, struggle with isolation, struggle with fear within me, struggle with the stress, anxiety, mental breakdown, psychological depression, the spiritual death I experience. Amidst all this, if you want to live, it is a struggle for existence, struggle to live and move, and you survive. And we are the survivors. It is our survival of the fittest. Not only the richest, not only the biggest, not only the most powerful, but you and I can survive and have our being if you and I struggle and improve our spiritual life, social life, medical life, health care, economic system, and all other which really matter the most. Therefore, dear brothers and sisters, I invite all of you, pause for a moment and think of the present situation. Think of our own self. Think of our family. Think of our neighborhood. Think of the people who are really affected terribly by this pandemic. Think of the people who are admitted in hospital. Think of the person who is on ventilation. Think of the person who is struggling for a breath. Think of the whole world and act upon. I invite all of you to struggle for existence and survival of the fittest. I believe I have come across to all of you with a message, and I request to perceive the truth in it. Struggle for existence and survival of the fittest. Every being born on earth wants to live and move. Let us live and move, adapting ourselves to all the changes, to all the challenges, to all the conditions in and around. I would like to put an end to this small topic with a beautiful quote, beautiful saying of St. Paul from the Bible. In his second letter to Timothy, 4 and 7, beautifully says, "I have fought a good fight. I have won the race. I kept the faith. I fought a good fight. I have won the race. And I kept the faith, which is true in your life and in my life, in the life of the human person. We're struggling for existence. We're fighting, and we do win. And we keep the faith, not fear of death, but faith that you and I have a well-being on earth.